That's what I get for shaking the can coming out here. But that's all right. That's better. It is the end of 2022. It is December 31st right now, New Year's Eve. And I'm out here in the wonderfully organized shop. There's a lot to go over in this video. And I'm going to try and bar a lot of details, because if I were to go into detail about everything I want to discuss, this would be 3 hours. As it stands, it's probably going to fit in with everything else I do on this channel and be, you know, 30 to 45 minutes. So, yeah, a lot to go over. Fortunately for you guys, I wrote everything down so that I don't forget what all I'm supposed to talk about. So let's get the piece of paper out here and get started. All right, so the first thing I really want to go over is channel performance this year, and I'm quite pleased. Given the stuff that I've uploaded and how I film it, I am very happy to report that this channel has gained 109 subscribers. So we're sitting at a grand total of 118 right now, and that's just as of 15 minutes ago, right before I came out here and started filming. So, yeah, that's amazing, and you guys have really, really come through for me on that. Because, and I know I wasn't asking anybody to like subscribe so I could get a certain number of subscribers for the end of the year. It was just, I thought, well, you know, wouldn't it be cool if I got over 100 subscribers before the end of the year? And I sure as heck did. And that really, that does my heart a world of good. I cannot express properly in words how much that means to me and how much I appreciate it, because when I subscribe to other channels and I watch their stuff, it's kind of a big deal. It's my way of saying, hey, I like what you're doing here. You know, I like how you do it, and I'm going to go ahead and subscribe to you. I don't take subscriptions or liking videos. I don't take any of that lightly. So consequentially, when somebody does that to me, when they subscribe or they like one of my videos, I translate that as meaning quite a bit. So it is much appreciated. So yeah, 109 subscribers this year. That was amazing. It really was. Channel views have done pretty good. Right now, the goal I'm trying to get the channel to is about 1,000 subscribers and at least 4,000 watch, is it minutes or hours? I think it's watch hours, because that's the minimum requirement you need to like apply for the YouTube Partner Program, which is essentially monetization. Now, I don't need to make a living off this channel. I really don't. But if I could pull a little bit of just passive income off of it that I could invest back into the channel, you know, maybe better cameras, multiple cameras, and maybe some better editing software, maybe a course that actually teaches me how to edit stuff professionally, because right now I'm just hillbillying it. I'm stunned. It's the end of the year. But anyway, you know what I mean. If I could have enough to pull off this channel in income to invest back into the channel, maybe have a little bit left over, that'd be awesome. But at the end of the day, this is a hobby, and I do this stuff to help people. And I think I've helped at least a couple people, which that's awesome. Oh, boy. So, I'm out here in the shop to start stuff, because there's just a ton of things to go over, and there's been a lot of work done in the shop, and a lot of stuff stacked up in the shop. That's going to be part of a future video, is that their pump jack. I wanted to do it earlier this year, but it didn't work out. There I go off on tangents again. Let's go ahead and check the list. Oh, yeah, channel performance. We're still on that. Okay, so the top three videos of 2022... were the back pressure sensor fix for the 6.4 Power Smoke. That was uploaded in January. I thought I had uploaded it in November of 21, but I guess not. It was in January of this year. That is sitting at about 5,000 views. That's the most viewed video on the channel right now, which, okay, a lot of people have searched for that, actually. I've got enough views and subscribers now that YouTube analytics is starting to kick in, and a lot of people search for that. So I feel that I've helped a couple of people with that. That's awesome. The second video, the second most popular video, the one with the second highest number of views anyway, is well, it's a video I wish I hadn't uploaded. It's a video about the 6-4 power stroke, because I guess that's what I'm building this channel on, is that freaking piece of crap. But the video concerning the 6-4 power stroke, the fuel rail sensor, pressure sensor replacement, I was saying, oh, don't do any of that, you know, don't take it to a mechanic, it's so hard to work on, and blah blah blah. And not 2 weeks after I uploaded that, I was replacing turbochargers on that same truck. So I've come a long way since my original attitude towards cracking stuff open. I used to be so scared of opening valve covers. And now, on that power stroke, I've had that same valve cover off like 8 times this year. It's ridiculous. In fact, I'm so good at getting that valve cover off, I can have everything out of there and that valve cover off in like under 15 minutes if I hurry. And that's including draining the antifreeze out. I need to pull that one heater hose off. If you guys watch the power stroke videos, you know what I'm talking about. But yeah, that video I regret making and uploading. I wish I had not made it. And I thought about deleting it multiple times. And at the end of the day, why is that box sagging there? And I'll have to look at that in a minute. What did I put in this box? What is in here? Oh, that's the AC stuff for my pickup. Anyway, back to the point. See, tangents. I'm getting bad about that. But that short video about the, oh, don't work on this, take it to a mechanic. I can't believe I was so skittish about that type of stuff. Because now I've done turbochargers on that same pickup. I've done a transfer case on it, a steering box. I've done all manner of other repairs to other things. I mean, we've replaced the steering pump on the versatile tractor that we've got, and I've done all manner of other things, and so I am not nearly as skittish about repairing stuff and cracking it open like that. Not to say that I'm careless, you know, I'm not gonna throw dirt in it or anything, but I'm not as much of a coward about it as I was. And like I said, I thought about deleting that video, and at the end of the day, I decided against it because I think transparency is important on this channel and with me. And so that leads me into the next point. I'm just kind of walking around. You guys can stare at all the crap that we have here in the shop. I hope you don't mind. We'll get to something more interesting in terms of scenery here in a minute. But the transparency thing. So my philosophy is, if you're going to follow someone, if you're going to watch what they do, if you're going to take stock in what they say, well, then you ought to know something about them, kind of how they think and how they go about stuff and things of that nature. So, in my opinion, you guys are going to watch what I do. You're going to listen to what I say. Well, then you might as well see that I am flawed, just like everyone else, because I could easily make a bunch of videos that makes me look really good, but I don't. And the reason I don't is because I think it's important for people to see that even guys that quote unquote know what they're doing are flawed, and they sometimes screw up. And that's not cussing on them. It's just, that's human nature. That's the way things go. So I want everybody that subscribes to this channel and really starts investing in watching my content, I want them to be able to see that, oh, he used to be like really scared to open stuff, and you could tell based on my earlier videos. And you would think, well, wait a minute, this is coming from the same guy that did a water pump in his own pickup and dropped the fuel tank and replaced the pump. Why was he scared of pulling a valve cover off of another engine? I don't know. The disconnect there is, well, it's something. So you guys can think of that what you will. But yeah, the transparency aspect I think is really important, which is why I have left that video up. And unfortunately, that is the second most viewed video on this entire channel. Very disappointed. So the third most popular video, which of course the wind came up enough to blow that on the floor. The third most popular video, speaking of the fuel pump, that's actually the third most viewed video on the channel, and that is from last year. So yeah, that's pretty cool, I guess. It honestly is not as bad to drop the tank on that on that F-250 of mine with the V10, it's not as hard to drop that fuel tank as I thought it would be. I actually did it again. I dropped that fuel tank again about July, I think. I dropped it again and replaced some fuel lines. I took some video of it, but I decided not to put it together into anything because it wasn't, pardon me, it wasn't really the best, so I decided against it. Oh my gosh. So what's next on the list? Yeah, that's right. Pontiac Silver 8 Streak. 1948, I believe, is what that car is. The inside's trash. I mean, it's absolutely destroyed. But it's been in the shop for the past 50 years, so the body and everything's okay. Anyway, what's next on the list? All right, well, I thank my subscribers. Thank you guys again, just in case you didn't hear. I mean, I really wish I could express it more articulately. If that's even a word. It's a word now. I made it up. But, I mean, I just didn't think I would gain so many subscribers so quickly based on the stuff I'm putting out. Because, really, in defiance of all my expectations, I didn't think that many people still had 6.4 Power Strokes. But I guess quite a bit of them do. I don't know why. They're crappy engines. I mean, somebody had just commented. I don't remember what the old boy's name was, but he had just commented on one of the Power Stroke videos, and he was talking about how they're a nightmare to work on. I'm like, yeah, that's the truth. And he said they run like a scalded dog when they're running right, and that is the truth. They will, man, you could put so much power to those damn things with just the stock components. It's ridiculous how much power you can get out of them. Ours is not tuned that hot. It's barely above the stock tune, but runs like a scalded dog. That's a good one. I'm probably going to use that from now on. And the other one that we use around here is run like a striped ass ape, but scalded dog. That's just hilarious. Channel performance. Oh, and equipment performance. Let's talk about that for a minute. So the Versatile, we're going to go over the Versatile here in a minute. But we started the year. The year hasn't really been the best for us. So we started the year with a combination of power smoke problems and Versatile problems. So right in here, that is the old steering pump off of that Versatile 800. It was replaced in June. I did a video about that. Well, the pump replacement was in it. And around here somewhere, I have what's left of the guts of the hydraulic distributor out of that same tractor. But I'll be damned if I can find out where I put it. Did I put it in the damn fridge over here, freezer? I don't know. Is it in the old Cervell? I don't know. That's about all the Freon we have left. We went through a ton of that. Anyway, the Versatile had some problems that cost us a lot of money. We started the year replacing. Oh my goodness! What we need to do before we continue is pay homage to Power Stroke Panther. Power Stroke Panther, I think you're the only reason this channel has so many subscribers. Kevin, there's nothing back there you need to get into. What are you doing? Being a Fruit Loop. Well, where was I? He's gonna be weird. What was I talking about? I don't remember. Oh, yeah, the year. It hasn't been very good. It's just because so many things broke, and the weather didn't cooperate, and stuff got expensive, and that all combined to just make a wonderful year. And on top of that, some other stuff happened too. So the Versatile got a lot of work done to it, and the 6.4, of course, got a lot of work done to it. You know, transfer case, steering box, turbochargers, it's gone through. I got one injector in it, number 7, that's working fine. And then I got the one injector in number 3 that's not working fine that I still have to diagnose. That pickup has also had, we finally got the back tires and the rims upgraded on it, stuff like that. The Versatile had a steering pump. We had the distributor rebuilt. We had the tachometer cable replaced, which it wasn't very expensive. The air conditioning was an absolute struggle. And then we also did the hydraulic remotes on the back of the tractor. And I'll just go over to the tractor and I'll show you guys all that, because we'll talk about it first and then we'll move on to the power smoke. All right, here we are at the Versatile. So this thing had to have some work done. We'll start at the beginning. The first thing that we had to do to this was get that hydraulic distributor right there rebuilt. Shout out to Helton Farm Repair again, because they rebuilt it, and the guy that rebuilt it said, he said that that was probably one of the worst units he had ever worked on, and he was surprised it was even working at all. And it was barely working, but we went ahead when we had this rebuilt. When we got it back, we had new hoses made up, and then we also rebuilt the remote bar here on the back, because before it had those stupid, it had those styles that had an arm that held it to a bracket, and then it had the two like circles on it that were supposed to grab just this part of the remote. It was stupid. We replaced all that, new remotes on, and we were going to do this whole elaborate thing of screwing it into this angle iron. Excuse me. And then we were working on it, and the boss man said, well, wait a minute, why don't we just weld the damn pipe nipples to it and just go on about our business? That's going to be a lot easier. You could see where he had tried to experiment a little bit there. And I mean, that was fine to me. And then we just welded the bar to the old mounts for the old remote holders. So we had all that done. And as you can imagine, this plus that distributor was quite a chunk of money, but it was worth it. This made an enormous difference in how all the implements performed. And the most important thing, we weren't hemorrhaging hydraulic fluid. If you will so acutely notice, right there's not a lot of grease and dirt and oil built up around that. Because before we had that replaced, you couldn't even see it. It would just look like a big wasp nest, just covered in dirt and stuff and oil and grease. It was a mess. So that was all fun. And then this is the remnants of the old remote system. So that was the first thing we had done to this. That made a huge difference. Now, we started running it, and then not long thereafter. Now, keep in mind, after we started running it, we were having the air conditioning problems, which I've gone over in another video. But then shortly after we started running it, Dad comes back one day and he says, oh, that tractor's not steering right. Well, this is the new pump. Again, Helton Farm Repair. They had one left, and they came through for us. So shout out to them again. But we replaced that, because first we had replaced this elbow here because it was leaking, and then it wasn't steering, so we replaced the pump, and we also got under here and replaced that great big suction line that goes all the way back to the tank. And why is that hose leaking on the bottom of the engine? Is that the return from the oil cooler? I'll bet it is. Well, that's okay. We just add more oil to this anyway. It uses a little bit. That's not too bad. So we got that hose replaced. Getting that thing off was a pain. And trying to put the old one back on, it didn't work. So we just got a new one. And after all that happened, a while later, on top of the air conditioning issues that we were still having, which were solved. That's a new compressor. It got a new low side light. We'll go over that in a minute. I got a new tachometer cable. That made a huge difference, because before, the tachometer needle would just sit there and do this when it was idling. It's a lot more stable now. So then, about mid-season, I had to come back here and replace that hose. And it runs up to the, I guess it's a flow control for the distributor. But that hose was leaking pretty bad. And so I was like, oh man, I need to get that off there. And I went to turn it with a wrench, and it just twisted apart. I mean, it was hardly holding together. I'm surprised it hadn't exploded already, to be honest with you. So all that happened. Then all the air conditioning stuff, we went through hundreds of dollars in Freon, probably 6 or 7 dryers. The guy at the local CarQuest, he was laughing at us. And eventually, after the 3rd dryer, I think, we came in there and he said, let me guess, you need another dryer. And yeah, we need one. So he was able to get him here quicker than anywhere else. And they weren't that expensive. They were only like $30, and that's not bad for a dryer. But you know, when you go through 6 or 7 of them, that adds up. When you go through Freon at $11 to $12 a can, that adds up pretty quick. And then we also had to put another compressor on it. And we were struggling with the air conditioning last year. It wasn't quite perfect. And we learned a lot of lessons. I learned a lot of lessons in particular, since you know, I did a lot of the stuff. The boss man was busy doing other things. But the biggest thing I learned with the air conditioning is that you need to make sure stuff's sealing correctly, because the vacuum pump we were using, the old gauge set we were using, the hoses we were using, all of that stuff was leaking, and I wasn't letting it draw a vacuum long enough anyway. And so, that was just a mess. But the air conditioning does work now. The only reason it doesn't work any better than the old system is because I think, because that's a condenser right there, and it's not very big, and it doesn't flow a lot of air over it. It's clean, but it doesn't flow a lot of air over it. And I think that's the only reason it wasn't getting any colder in the cab. Combine that with the fact that this is old 1974 glass, you know, it's not really reflecting anything. It's more like a magnifying glass than anything. But yeah, the Versatile, that was a lot of headache. So speaking of the Versatile, I want to explain this the best way I can, because this is going to help explain problems in the future when I bring up VHS. I call it Versatile Hydraulic Syndrome. And understanding it is pretty simple. Basically, you have a machine. You call it a tractor, you call it a car, whatever. I'm going to use this tractor in the hydraulic system as an example. But you have an old machine. Everything on it is original or relatively original. It starts wearing out, right? So as it starts wearing out, you pick a component that is the worst. In this case, the distributor. We pick that. We have it rebuilt. We put new hoses on, new remote bar, everything. Well, that stops all those leaks. And it starts putting more pressure on the system because it's not, you know, leaking all that pressure out and leaking all that fluid out. So because all that stuff is new, it puts more pressure on the rest of the system. So then on this tractor, you have more pressure on a system because of the distributor and remotes being good and the hoses. So then you come up and there's an elbow on a steering pump that leaks. So you replace that. And so you replace that, and then the steering pump goes out because turns out it's old and worn out when you're putting all that, you know, new pressure back on it. It doesn't like it very much. So then you replace that, and you replace the suction line, and then you come through, and then the supply line back here that goes from the tank up to the distributor goes out. So then you replace that too. And it's just a never-ending battle of replacing stuff because everything was worn out. And then as one thing starts to get worn out to the point you can't use it and you start replacing components, then the weaknesses of the other components come to light. So it feels like a money pit, even though realistically all that stuff was old and it needed to be replaced. There's nothing wrong with the machine, it just needed some love. And that is Versatile Hydraulic Syndrome, and you can apply that kind of logic to all sorts of other stuff. It's like you get a car and, you know, it's kind of old and you're like, oh, I need to do the brakes and the tires on it. Well, a tire blows out, so you put two new tires on the front of the back. Oh, and then the other two tires blow out. And you're like, well, crap, now I got to go do that. And then your brakes don't work, so you do your brakes. And you're like, well, goddamn, I did my brakes, and now that I'm not vibrating everything, I could tell my wheel bearings are going out. And it's just a cycle. Everything wears to itself, and then you start putting new components in, and you change the whole wear formula and performance formula of everything, and it's just a mess. And that's what we have with this tractor. So we're going to have to put a lot more hydraulic hoses on this coming season, I think. And we're also going to have to pull the steering cylinders off and get them rebuilt, because they are leaking and it's not wanting to steer. And so we need to get all of that done. But the Versatile, yeah, it took some work this year. Oh, and then we come over to everyone's favorite, the 6.4 Power Smoke. Oh my goodness, Super Duty my ass. Doesn't even run long enough to do hardly anything with. When it runs right, runs great. So here are those back wheels that we put on. They match the front now. The outfit we got this from was an oil field outfit, and I imagine they had some tires that blew out, so they just robbed some rims off of something else and threw it on this. And when we replaced the transfer case, it didn't take us very long, and we went ahead and put good rims on so that we could run the transfer case without, you know, destroying it, because I'm pretty sure that didn't help the original transfer case. But as I said before, this thing got, you know, tires. It's had tires put on it, of course, rims, two injectors. Well, really, I bought three, but it's got two good ones in it right now. It's had, you know, the turbochargers, and they're working fine. The transfer case, and it's working fine, and then the steering box. And we knew the steering box was going out when we had it aligned last year. The the alignment guy said, hey, you need to do your steering box. So, yeah. And everything's still good. He even got a new forward drive shaft. Can't show it to you. It's covered in oil anyway because freaking... How many miles does his engine have on it? I don't remember. His key's... Yeah, key's still in it. Why would we bring it in? Who would want to steal this damn thing? There you go. 279,799 miles. What a piece of junk. But it's gone. Those turbos have about 20,000 miles? I don't remember. When did we replace them? Was it at 245 or 263? I think it was at 263,000 miles. So no, I guess it doesn't quite have 20 on them. But it's got quite a few thousand miles on them. That's the point. And they're fine. So the power smoke is going to have to get some attention. But the strain is off of us now somewhat because the cows have already been hauled and the grain's already been gotten. And look who it is, Power Stroke Panther. You gonna fix this for me, cat? We're not gonna... I've done enough on this for the year. I just wanted to show you guys the fancy new shiny wheels. Oh, it needs rear brakes. The rear calipers, the lower slide pin boot, I guess deteriorated and started rotting out the slide pins. So now this side in particular, it just is on all the time grinding. I've got the stuff to fix it, but since this pickup's not running right, I am in absolutely no rush to put brakes on it. But we'll get there. And then there's that grain trailer. So one of the things that's been killing us this year, one of the reasons the year didn't go all that well, is because it started raining in spring. We had a good wet spring, and then it turned off hot and dry. And I mean very hot. Triple digits all the time, and it didn't rain pretty much from the middle of June. We didn't get a real rain until November, more or less. And so because of that, the grass didn't grow. There was no wind, thankfully, so it didn't, you know, dry the ponds up or anything, but the grass was struggling all summer. And the old cows there, they have been getting hay for about the past month and a half, almost 2 months. They've been getting hay because, well, there's no rye because it's still growing because it got dry and then it didn't rain till November and then it got cold. So we're still waiting on the rye to grow. So I've been hauling hay with my pickup for about the past 30, 40 days. Is it closer to 2 months now? I don't remember, but yeah, we fed them quite a bit. They're good girls. So I've been having to drive quite a bit to get the hay because we have a guy that comes down here and rents the pasture from us. He brings about 200 head down to the property here, and he's a real easy guy to get along with, and he's saved our skin quite a few times. And, you know, we don't mind if he leaves his cows here a little longer than he's supposed to because he's busy, spread out everywhere. And we've saved his bacon a few times. I know he appreciates it. So I'm driving about 80 miles north of where we live here to go and get hay from one of his multiple hay stockpiles. And oh yeah, see, that cylinder's real bad. That's probably the one that's not letting us steer. Anyway, I've been hauling hay going up to one of his locations and getting it for a while. And I've been using my pickup to do it, and it's been doing pretty well. So let's go have a gander at it real quick. Why? Why do you have to... You know you can't come inside when you're dirty. Why did you do that? Oh my gosh, Kevin. All right, so yeah, this has been doing really good over the past couple months. I've had one major problem with it. Well, brakes. That was a problem just because the slide pins needed to be greased. I need to unhook the bale loader before it drains my battery. And right here is where I've been having the problem with this pickup. When it gets really cold outside, the speedometer doesn't work. And so I thought, well, crud, that's probably the wheel speed sensors, because I only had the passenger one connected. And then in July, when I did the fuel tank I was talking about, I dropped it and did lines, fuel lines. I also put the rear speed sensor, a new one, in the rear differential. I kept the old speed sensor. I don't think it was bad, but the pigtail was all chewed off. So I put a new pigtail on, new sensor. So I had that speed sensor, and I had the passenger front wheel one here. So then it got so stinking bad, the speedometer wouldn't hardly work at all. And my brakes were really bad. I mean, they were just beating the front end to death when you stepped on them. They're better now. Not perfect, but they're better. I need to put new parts on, but I haven't ordered them yet. Anyway, I put the speed sensor on that side, and I put the speed sensor on this side. I bought them back in July. I was going to put them on, and then I thought, ah, no, those are stupid. That's just for the anti-lock brakes. Well, because I'm half stunned, I didn't realize at the time, that's also, the speed sensors also tell your speedometer how fast you're freaking going. But I had them, so I put everything on. That side even got a new pigtail. And I cleaned everything up, and I'd also done my caliper slide pins at the same time. I put everything back together, and it seems to work fine. And then it gets cold, and it's still not working. So one day, I'm coming back from getting hay. I'm a mile from getting the bale, and the speedometer's acting up. It was fine all the way up there, and then it started being stupid. So I get mad, and I come out here, and I find out that that cable's loose. And that this is not super loose, but this, I guess, is super touchy. So apparently, if this is even a little bit loose, this one in particular, I believe, it's bolted, it's nutted on here now, because before it would just be like this, and I'd put the bail order cord over it and then put the wing nut on. That would be making this loose all the time, and I think that's why this wasn't working, because it would vibrate a little bit and settle, and then it would just kind of arc out and not be right. So the reason my speedometer hasn't been working is because this has not been staying tight. And the ground, you know, I've never had a problem with the ground. It's, yeah, it's not moving. It's good. And the boss man, because this used to be his pickup, he said he had a horrible time keeping particularly the positive cables and the terminal connectors on this damn truck. It was a real problem. And the Excursion is similar. They'd always work loose. But with the Excursion, the bigger thing was they would start corroding. And I greased them the last time I put terminal connectors on. I greased them and tightened them down real good. Never had a problem with it since. And I guess that's what I need to do to this, is take it apart and grease the terminals. I need to have this battery out, because I'm going to fix my washer system, replace the lines, so I can clean my windshield on the go. When I get a chance. Got to stop hauling hay first. Got to go up every day and do that. It's about 3 to 4 hour trip every day to get all that done. But this pickup has been run, I'm going to say fairly hard, reasonably hard anyway. Go ahead and put that wing nut back on there. I don't want to lose it. This is a better system to power that bale loader, to hook the power cord up, than connecting it on the bed, if you can believe it. But this thing's been doing pretty good. It needs an oil change. And yesterday, I just put over 10,000 miles since I got it going, all the way back in October, November of 2021. So I think I started at 187,283, and now I'm at 197,464. And it's been running, other than that speedometer issue and the brakes, I mean, it's been running fine. I've had no problems. Everything's been working good. The only other, I just need to do some minor things to it. And then as we start warming up come spring, it's going to get some air conditioning work done, because my air conditioner didn't work all that well over the summer, and that was fun. But yeah, speedometer is the only issue, and it was just because I think electrical problems, and when you've got a 21-year-old vehicle, that's not surprising, you know? So it's been doing good. I need to get a seat cushion ordered for this, though. The boss drove it the other day, and he was all, oh my gosh, I didn't know the seat was that broke down. I'm like, well, yeah, I'm not the one that drove it for 160,000 miles. That was you, man. So the Dewey's bale loader back here, which I want to do a video on, but it's been doing real good. The biggest problem we have had in the past with this bale loader is the power cord and the control solenoid right there. The solenoid, they just burn out, so I put a new one on this year. And the original, I can't remember, is this whole unit replaced, or did he just replace the motor?
But most of this is largely original. These are outstanding bail loaders. Bolt on, and I got my toolbox fixed up to where everything works. I mean, it's been doing good. This thing probably weighs about 800 pounds. So you put 800 pounds of bail loader on, and then you put anywhere from 1,000 pounds to maybe 1,200 pounds. Depends on the type of bail I get when I go, because the guy's got some older hay, and he's got some newer hay, and the older hay was baled real wet, so it's lighter. I mean, it's perfectly green. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just a lighter bale. It's not as dense. And the other hay, it's a little newer and better. It is more dense, noticeably more dense. I have to push the pickup a little harder to get up to speed with that bale on. That's what I've been getting. Everything seems to be fine. But yeah, you know, you figure you're getting anywhere from 1,800 to maybe 2,000 pounds right on the back of this thing. And it moves. It's just not happy about it. The V10 does not like to move unless you give it a lot of RPM. You know, it likes RPMs, and it likes fuel. Loves fuel. 10 miles a gallon, that's what I get with this. And it doesn't, any mileage I might get driving long distance at a consistent speed is immediately negated the minute I start driving back roads and I put a load on this. So, you know, that's the way she goes. But those are the three big things, equipment-wise, that I've had to screw with this year. And it's all been working great for the most part. This pickup, it just needs a little bit of attention on some minor things. And once the rye comes up a little bit more, it's been pretty nice this past week. We give it a few more days. I was looking out there. It's getting there. I can see it from the house. I can see how green it is. But in a few more days, we should be able to hopefully turn the cows out, and then I'll haul hay for about another week to stockpile in case it gets cold, and then they should be able to eat on that and be fine. Yeah, it's leaking a little bit back here. I want to fill this thing, but you got to be careful, because if you fill it when the cylinder is all the way full and then you grab a bale and it's pushed the ram all the way in, then you fill this up and you overflow it and it makes an even bigger mess. But this bale loader does pretty good. Probably maybe should replace those hoses. They're a little worn. Yeah, a little bit. And I need to get that light put in too, but I don't care. Most of the lights back here work. That's all that matters. Oh, this thing. Well, yeah, we'll talk about that in a minute. That's part of a later section. And here's the sideboards for the dump trailer. We were using that dump trailer, the grain trailer, to go get hay until the power smoke quit. All right, so channel performance and equipment performance. We just got done with that. So planned projects. All right, so a lot of you guys are probably waiting on Caterpillar stuff. The Caterpillar is a toy and a hobby, and I would love to be able to get back to it, but I've got other things to do, and we'll go over that. So the planned projects for 2023, we've got quite a bit. We've got the 6.4. We've got the Intersmashable right here, 1586. I hate this thing. The only thing I like about it is this engine right here, DT-436. Outstanding engine. But the rest of the tractor, useless. This thing is gutless. It beats you to death. It's short coupled. If you turn this, if you try and turn sharp out in the field, you'll just plow forward with this. It's absolute junk. It's touchy. Everything's worn out on it. And even if it wasn't, it's just a piece of crap and I don't like it. And so then you might be wondering, well, what's wrong with it? Why is it sitting here? It's sitting here because the reverse gear is missing more than one tooth. Let's just say that. It's missing more than one. And so, consequentially, it does not want to go in reverse. So that's a bit of a problem. Also, the starter gave out. There's a whole story behind it I'm not going to get into right now. But this is a future project that I would love to get taken care of, not because I want to use this, but because I want it gone. I don't want to screw with it. I don't want to look at it. It's an eyesore. It always has been. I just don't like these damn things. If we could afford to, if we didn't need to trade this or sell it, I would just say, let's rip the motor out and throw the rest of the tractor in a scrap pile. And the loader, too, because the loader's not any good. Freaking Westendorf piece of crap. And as you can see, let's see, that goes over the transmission and the shift linkage. And then right over here, we've got the classic International 66 and 86 series shift linkage. This is just useless. It's been sitting out here for a while, hence the rust. This is just a horrible tractor. I just don't like it. And I don't really care what happens to it in terms of stuff getting rusted. I just want to do enough to fix it, and then we can trade it, and somebody else can mess with it. When we fix it, it's going to be done right. I don't want to screw over the next guy. There's a seat. I don't know how much, I don't know how extensive we're going to get with this. I know we're going to get in there and do the transmission stuff right, but I don't know when. That takes a lot of time. So that's a planned project. One of the current projects right here, this is one of my sister's. This is her car. It's a 2006 Focus. I just put an alternator on it. Still having electrical problems. Need to trace some lines there. So this is a planned project. We got a skid steer, Bobcat T200, and it's got a major leak on the hydrostat. We've been able to run it a little bit over the winter just because the fluid is cold, but I mean, the leak is just something awful. And when we bought it, excuse me, just a second. Anyway, we bought the skid steer. We paid for it. You know, it wasn't like finance or anything. Paid cash for it. And the guy we bought it from, he's like, oh yeah, there's nothing wrong with it. It's got 5,000 hours on it. He said the tracks are probably needing to be replaced. And they are. Okay, that's not a big deal. And he said, other than that, everything works great on it. No door. Well, that's okay. The first skid steer we had didn't have a door. The old 743. I'll do a walk around of it one of these days. That old 743 was a real trooper. But it's T200. He's like, all it needs is tracks. And it doesn't have a door on it. And there's no climate control stuff. We're like, well, pfft. Most of the equipment we run around here doesn't have climate controls. If you think about it, I mean, the Versatile half the time doesn't have air conditioning. My pickup doesn't really have good air conditioning. The International's air conditioning might work sometimes when it was running. What else was there? Well, the original skid steer didn't have air conditioning. The D4 doesn't have air conditioning. It doesn't have anything, actually. And then, you know, so we get another skid steer. It's got no air conditioning in it. We're like, well, that's not a big deal. We can put a unit in. And then we get it here. We have it shipped here and everything. And we're like, yeah, tracks need to be replaced pretty quick, but not bad. And then this freaking leak on the hydrostat. I mean, it's going through fluid like you wouldn't believe. Which would be... it's bad enough. I don't think stop leak would fix it. But the bigger thing is that the machine is not right. If you try and ease it into something, it gets all jerky, you know, and it's worse when it's hot. And when we've used it a little bit, we keep an eye on the fluid, and I keep putting fluid in it when we have to run it. That's how we had to put the bail loader on my pickup. But just the number of things we could have done with that damn skid steer. And we get it, and for what we paid for it, there should have been nothing wrong with it. Tracks, okay, that's not the end of the world. We could get tracks for a couple thousand put on. They're not hard to do. But the freaking hydrostat, I can't do anything with it. I didn't have time. Even if I can see it, I know what the problem is, but I can't get in there and actually fix it. I don't have room. Stuff would have to come out. You'd about have to have another skid steer or, you know, a shop that's not this to be able to work on it and to fix it, because you'd have to be able to lift stuff off and pick things up and move big heavy things out of the way that we don't have the equipment to do. And that really screwed us up. I mean, it really did. We could have done so much with that damn skid steer, but nope, lied through his teeth. I don't remember what the name of the outfit is, but that bastard ever watches this channel and he sees that, screw you. I mean, you really messed us up, man. And that's put it lightly. So much could have been done this past year that would have made us feel better about things. But no, now we got to put it all off till next year. But whatever happens. So that has to be fixed by someone that's not us. We'll get to that. Other projects. Well, the Versatile, like I said, it's going to need some cylinder rebuilding, and we're going to have to do, like,
Well, okay, here's skid steer. Here's an example. This Pontiac right here is in the way because I'll back up. All right, so I've done my best with all of this, which it looks like an episode of Hoarders. I can't do much more with it because the Pontiac is in the way. If the skid steer was working, we could have cleaned the shop out and come in here with that, and we could have gotten like casters and put under this thing and rolled it and then pulled it out with the skid steer and moved it out of the shop so that we can actually do stuff in here. Well, no, we can't do that because the skid steer is broken. There's all sorts of limb piles, wood piles, scrap shuttles that I'm not going to show on camera just because I don't want to embarrass myself. This place is a mess. And it's better than it was. It's like a lot better than it was, but it's still not where it should be because we haven't had a skid steer that's worked in a couple of years. So we're doing all that. That needs to be all done. And, I've got tractors to do and things like that. The excursion still needs some work, which will be filmed. I've got parts for it right here. I got freaking got lights, and where did I put the fuel injectors for it? I stuck them somewhere. Kevin, where did I put the fuel injectors for the excursion? I put them up here. Well, those are the automotive light bulbs. Oh yeah, those are the injectors right there. So, we've got all that to do, and we've got 10,000 freaking filters, and those are all parts. Those two big boxes are air filters, outer air filters for that Versatile. They're getting hard to get, so we ordered two of them. Took them a while to come in. That was a problem. Supply chain stuff, it got us. The fuel prices got us. The equipment not working killed us. The extra money that we had to go to paying increased fuel costs and unexpected machine repairs. I'm talking about the 6.4, like tires and stuff, we account for that. The Versatile, it needed some hydraulic stuff. Well, that was kind of a surprise, but not unexpected, really. I'm talking about stuff like, well, I hung them up. That bucket, and I think that one there too. All three of those are full of them little Freon cans. That's how much Freon we went through in that damn tractor. It was a mess. And all that stuff and more is why the year just didn't work out super well for us, but, it could have been a lot worse. Like I said, even though it was dry, the wind didn't blow, so we didn't lose excess moisture that way. We didn't have to work the field as much, which is good because the price of fuel was high. It's coming down a little bit now, but it's still not where it should be. But we didn't get screwed too hard on that just because, with nothing's growing out in the field, you don't need to go till it, so you don't need to burn fuel, which also doubled as a benefit because that gave me time to finally figure out how to, get the air conditioning working on the tractor. Fixing the F2, the power stroke, that was a good experience. It wasn't fun, but it was a good experience. Stuff like that, just combination of things such as that just killed us. Current projects. I got away from the list. I got going off on tangents. We got a lot more to talk about, I'm afraid. Knew this was going to be like an hour and a half video, but whatever. No one's going to watch it. I don't really care. Current projects. Well, current project. Ford Focus. Another current project. That pickup. Don't look at that car. We don't care about that car. It's a quad 442 Oldsmobile, though. I don't. My uncle owns it, but those tires right there are the ones that came off the back of that Power Smoke. But current projects right now, I'm just working on the Focus, focusing on the Focus, and then I need some wiring diagrams, like professional Ford level diagrams for the Power Smoke, and then I can get to work on it and we'll get that figured out one way or another. Those are really the only two current projects that I'm doing that I can focus on. There's some other stuff too, but No, I guess I really that's about it. Just trying to get stuff like that fixed, and then I'll get back out here to the shop, clean it up again, and get some stuff ready so that come springtime, I don't have to fart around with all these little projects that should have been done over the wintertime. Those are the current projects. Not really an extensive list. which is good, but the only reason it's not larger is because everything else is either broke to the point I don't want to screw with it and I can't, or there's just nothing else we can do right now. It's not warm enough outside and things of that nature. So, self-improvements. Why did I write that? Oh, yeah. Changes that have happened to me. I have not like physical changes. I haven't become deformed. More like the attitude I take towards fixing stuff. I mentioned earlier, I'm not as skittish about opening stuff up and working on it. That was a huge change because I used to be really scared about all that. So that was a big deal. I've learned a little bit more about editing. The editor I use has gotten an upgrade. That makes a huge difference in performance because it used to be really slow and clunky and it ate up my computer's RAM and CPU. And if I tried to do too many things at once, or if I tried to do them too quickly, it would just crash. But this recent update, it was a big one, and it really makes that thing run a lot more smoothly. So the editing stuff has improved, and it will continue to improve. I've accumulated, of course, more knowledge and more tools and more parts, and that's always good. So, you know, like I got more air conditioning, little air conditioning tools and stuff. I spent a lot of time researching that and accumulating it. So I'm pretty well set up there on the air conditioning side. I've got some other little tools that I had to have for other stuff. That was nice. You know, that was an improvement. Having my pickup going, that blue one, that's made a big difference around here because now we can at least continue to do something. You know, that V10, it's not going to pull a trailer full of cows. It doesn't like it. It's not good at it. So we still need the diesel for that, but at least we've got a pickup we can do some stuff with. Like if we had to go get fuel or whatever, we can at least do that, you know, because we've got two pickups. That's a huge improvement. And you know, that really, and the reason I mentioned that in the self-improvements thing here is because having that thing working and knowing that it works and knowing that like the water pump and the injectors and the plugs and everything that I did last year, it's gone 10,000 miles. It's run a year. It has not had easy miles the past couple months. I've run it pretty damn hard and it's held together. So that gives me confidence that I at least know what I'm doing somewhat, which is a big deal. Other self-improvements. I'm hammering out my video style, which I guess is to just make longer videos, if this one is any indication. Hammering out the video style, that's a big thing because I started the year still kind of awkward, and I think I've improved. You guys can correct me if I'm wrong, but I think I've improved quite a bit. And what else? Well, figuring out the right balance of entertainment and seriousness. I'm trying to pick a lane here with stuff, and I'm still figuring out the whole video thing, you know, how I want to do it, and getting good camera angles, and the dialogue, and what I want to show, and what all I need to talk about, how I need to say it, things like that. You know, that all takes some time, and I think I've improved some there. Long ways to go, but no, I'm getting there. You guys can, again, correct me if I'm wrong. I'm trying to think if there's anything else really major self-improvements that are worth talking about. Those are the big ones, though. Hammered out my style. I've got more confidence in fixing stuff. I've learned a lot. I've accumulated more special tooling. I approach things differently in a better way. And just stuff like that, just normal improvements, big deal. Yeah, plenty of room to improve still. There went a cardinal up there in the old maple tree. I'd show him, but he's far away enough. I couldn't pick him up on camera. So yeah, and then of course the channel performance has reflected the little bit of effort that I have put in, which is awesome. And I hope that I can put better effort in and get more of a response this coming year. I'm looking forward to that. I think if we can get some of these equipment problems squared away and we can get prepared, I think we'll be all right. And we're planning on making some changes here to maybe speed things along in the profitability department. That would be awesome if it all works out. So we got some stuff we're looking at doing there. Got some new equipment we're looking at getting. Not new, like old. New to us, if you will. So I don't know how that's going to go down, so I don't want to go into detail about it, but we're looking at that. We're looking into it, just trying to speed things along around here, because every year that we're closer and closer to getting out of debt on this place, it's just harder and harder to get a yard ahead for every yard we keep getting ahead, you know? And we're going to try and speed that process along without setting us backwards too much. Things like that. So, self-improvements, blah, blah, what else? Future plans, so the channel. What direction am I going to take the channel in? I want to do the same things I'm doing now. I want to get away from the Power Stroke because I don't want this to be a one-trick pony type of channel. There's still going to be videos on fixing the vehicles and stuff. There will be videos, more videos on the Versatile and the other equipment. I promise you guys I'm going to get back to that Caterpillar as soon as I can because I want to get it back together. It's getting to be close to a year since it's run last. That's not good for it. I'm not worried about it. It'll fire up and everything. It just, I don't like to leave stuff sit that long. Like I mentioned, some of the vehicles and equipment we still have to fix. All the stuff that we end up getting, if we get it, that will all have to have repairs done to it. So that'll be some videos there. I want to try and do more stuff. And even though it's difficult to do it during the summer, I'm going to try and make an effort to get the camera out and at least do a summary of some stuff. You know, throw you guys a bone a little bit. And expand out into some different types of content. Like, you know, maybe do some more YouTube shorts. Those seem to be somewhat popular if I can do them right. Maybe make some shorter videos. This is going to be a long ass damn video. I've gone on for 30 minutes. Can you believe that, Panther? I sure as hell can. I could jaw on for 3 hours about nothing and it wouldn't be, I wouldn't even be breaking a sweat. But stuff like that. I just want to do what I'm doing now and improve the editing a little bit. I want to add a little bit of more silliness into it. Not too silly. I've got a channel dedicated to all the stupid, silly stuff that I would normally do. But, you know, I want to add a little more silliness in, make this stuff a little more entertaining, be not quite so dry and boring and monologuing. But the biggest way I could get rid of the monologuing is to shorten the length of the videos. But that would require me to cut out details. And I made up my mind a while back that I'm not going to do that. So transparency and blah, 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 and all the things like that. So that's pretty much what I want to do with the channel. There's some specific videos that I've wanted to do for a while now, like, well, I got that pump jack that needs to be opened up and checked, because that's the one we were running this year on the well. I've got this pump jack that I haven't messed with in 2 years. It should be fine, but I want to open it up and do a video showing you guys how these things come apart and what to look for on them and stuff like that. I've wanted to do that for a while, actually, but never had time. Now that I got the tripod, I can, though. Some other stuff. You know, we get the skid steer fixed, a ton of stuff is going to get cleaned up around here. I like this freaking car. I don't, this car, man, silver 8 streak, inline 8 on this thing. Anyway, get that cleaned up, get the shop cleaned up, build a better bench, get a vise, because that's the old vise. I broke it. It had one too many cheaters put on it, and it had been beat with hammers one too many times, and she finally quit. And when she did, that hurt. I'll leave it at that. I can see I got the freaking Caterpillar stuff out here. I haven't forgotten about it. Just stuff like that. Get things cleaned up. Build a better bench. Get a better shop set up. Improve, clean some things up around here. Make the place a little more presentable. Level out the freaking driveway and the lease roads so that we can actually park level and we don't have to go 2 miles an hour down the hills out in the field because, you know, it's rough because it's washed out and we don't have anything to go fix it with. Get some of these damn trees cleaned up around here. Fix up some fences. Just normal stuff. Those are the kinds of improvements I want to make around here and I'd like to do some videos on them. And if I can put the money together and I can find some decent cameras and some more tripods, then I'll do, you know, more in-depth videos if I can. I need something that's not my phone to film during the summer because this phone gets hot so stinking fast. So I need to figure that out, definitely. I need to finish this before the bugs get in it. It's warm enough today the bugs are going to come out. Anyway, You know, once you have this A&W stuff fresh at the store, at the restaurant, it's never as good. It's still good, but it's never as good as getting it fresh right from the tap. Where was I? Oh, yeah, anyway, those are all the future plans. Normal farm stuff, but I want to show more of it. I don't want to be quite so secretive. I'm not going to tell you guys where I live or anything like that. I don't want to get too personal here. But a little more detail and showing you guys a little more of what we do and how we do it around here would be, I think, kind of cool. I think that would help the channel grow. And as it concerns channel growth, subscribers, and views, I care more about views than I do subscribers because I think people will subscribe on their own if they like what I do. And I would much rather have quality of subscribers over quantity of subscribers. I don't want to do one type of video, have a bunch of people subscribe because they think, oh, he's going to do a ton of videos on that and I want to see it. And then I stop and move on. And they're like, well, I want more of this type of content. I'm like, well, I don't need to do that anymore because it's fixed or it's broken to the point where I don't want to mess with it anymore and we're moving on. And then a bunch of people leave because I'm moving on. I don't want that. I'd much rather have slower growth, higher quality subscribers than rapid growth and low quality subscribers. And if I said that backwards, I will maybe correct it in editing. So stuff like that is kind of what I'm thinking. The biggest thing I'm thinking right now is that in my head, I knew this was going to be a super long video, and I was hoping I could make it shorter, but it didn't work out that way. So I'm trying to wrap it up here, see if there's anything else that needs to be discussed. No, I don't think so. I think I've jawed on enough for one video, one final monologue for 2022. I still gotta get in and scramble and get this damn thing edited, exported, and uploaded. It may be next year. It may be next year. Tomorrow's January 1st. Next year. Yeah. Well, anyway, I don't know. That's pretty much the gist. Thank you guys again for subscribing. I mean, it means the world to me. I know a lot of people, you know, they let the social media stuff go to their head. And they really just get disgusted when they don't get like 200 million thousand views on their videos when they usually get 300 million thousand or whatever. I don't really care. I do the stuff that I want to do that I think people might find useful or interesting. And if they get views, they get views. And if they don't get views, they don't get views. And this is one of those videos that I like to do, but it's no one's going to watch it. And not because it's super long, just because, well, it's not a subject anybody really cares about. This is geared for my subscribers. If you made it to all the way to the end of this, then bless your heart. And fun fact, I do community posts. Now, YouTube's probably not recommending them to you, but if you subscribe here, go check out the community tab on this channel because occasionally I'll throw out a community post. It's a nice feature. I like it. It's a good way for me to stay connected to you guys. And that just makes everybody feel better, I guess. I don't know. I was going to say something else. I forgot what it was. But anyway, check out the community tab because I do use that. And yes, I do have two other YouTube channels. But this next year, I need to put stuff out on them. So if the feed runs dry over the spring and summer, I might be putting stuff out on these other channels. I haven't abandoned this one, just that might be what happens. That's the other thing I needed to mention. I have two other channels. I need to put content out on them because I, you know, gotta diversify, gotta cover all your bases. I may not get a lot from anything, but if I get a little bit from a lot, then I'll be okay, if that makes any sense. So this has gone on for a little bit, so I'll go ahead and cut it here. Thank you guys for making the channel a little bit more popular through 2022. Really appreciate it. I'm looking forward to 2023 for a variety of reasons. I am ready to put 2022 behind me. It was not the best year, definitely not the worst year, but it was certainly far from the best. So we're going to hope better for the next year like we usually do and just see how she goes. So I'll cut it off here. Thank you guys for watching. Really appreciate it. And stay tuned because as soon as I can, I'll have some more stuff coming out in January. Yeah. She clocked in a little bit much.
Unfortunately, I think my first New Year's resolution will be to maybe make shorter videos, because this is just getting ridiculous. Before you know, I'm going to be uploading entire sagas of useless rambling and monologuing, but yeah. You know, I've noticed that a bunch of the other channels I subscribe to, they post recaps and they're like under 10 minutes, and then here I am and I clock in with an hour and 4 minutes. Oh, crap. So, all right. It's, 6:50 right now. So, if we figure 3 hours to export and 30 minutes to upload, I don't know. I'm going to be cutting it awfully damn close, but I think I can get her up before the end of the year. So, I'm just going to tack this little post-editing bit onto the end, and I'll move on with my stuff.